check.
Kia ora and welcome back to the Hot Winter Festival. My name is Joe Maikipa and I am with
Matai Smith. Kia ora everybody.
What brings you to Taita today?
What brings me to Taita today? Beautiful Taita. Well, I am here as a representative of a kaupapa called Te Reo Wainene Otua, which is all about sharing our stories in Te Reo Māori with tamariki and rangatahi like we saw today. So it's a privilege and an honour to be a part of this kaupapa, but also to come to beautiful Taita as well. I used to work on the Good Morning Show. We used to film in a place called Avalon Studios just up the road there, and so it's nice to come back into Taita and see the beautiful people of this place.
What's your favourite Māori story?
Being from Te Tai Rāwhiti from Gisborne, born and bred, we were raised with the stories of Māui. That's not Māui on Moana, by the way, that's the actual proper Māui. So, you know, whether it was the story around him slowing down the day, you know, slowing down Tamanui Te Rā, or fishing up the North Island, or trying to defy death with Hine Nui Te Pō, or getting the fingernails from Hine Mahuika. All of those stories pertaining to Māui were stories that resonated with me as a kid, and I guess because his waka is back home in Te Tai Rāwhiti in Gisborne, in our region back home, that's probably the story that I most love, is the one about him fishing up the North Island.
What are you doing for Matariki this year?
I think the question should probably be, what am I not doing for Matariki? So apart from Te Reo Wainene Otua, I've been up in Auckland hosting a couple of big Matariki events run by the Auckland City Council. So first of all, a couple of weeks ago I hosted Te Korokoro Festival, which was a musical festival right outside the Sky City Casino. They shut off the street, Federal Street, and we had a stage, and we had the likes of Macy Reka, the Poi Boys, and all these other wonderful acts performing. I was the MC along with another colleague called Kaylee, and so we were the MCs, and we looked out to the crowd, and not only were there Māori there to celebrate Matariki, but also lots of Lions supporters, because it was during the time of the rugby, so our crowd was just a sea of red. And one of the wonderful things I think about Matariki is that it's starting to grow in terms of its popularity, and also it's starting to be seen and heard around the country. And my hope in terms of Matariki is one day we might be able to celebrate it as a holiday as opposed to other boring kaupapa like Labour Day.
Hey, do you have any advice for us to help us in television and film work?
I think first and foremost you've got to have a passion for film and television. I think when I was growing up I was always watching television. So back in the day we had people like Richard Long and Judy Bailey who used to read the news, and they used to fascinate me as a kid. And then we had Jason Gunn, who was a children's television presenter. And then I had the likes of a lady by the name of Tini Molyneux, who was the reader of Te Kariri. So those are sort of...